Bless his name. Let not your mind wander anywhere. You were created to worship him, give him praise. Humble yourself tonight and say, Lord, come into my heart, search my heart. See if there's any offensive way in me. Deliver me from any power of darkness and help me to be the best you have created me to be. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, give glory to the Lord. Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. May your holy name be exalted. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And as of tonight, even as we're about to pray, is he will be attentive to our prayer. He will hear us. Visit us tonight. Heal us tonight. Forgive us tonight. Empower us tonight. Father, we humble ourselves before you tonight. Thank you for this privilege, Lord. We don't take it for granted. Papa, you know the Bible says that, Lord, teach me to number my. So tonight I'm here, Lord, to worship you and to honor you, to adore you, who have loved me with your all. Be thou exalted. Be thou in praise tonight. Into my heart, Lord. Stay and live in me. I am yours forever and ever. And tonight, Lord, let your name be glorified. We come against every work of the enemy. We frustrate the plans of the enemy. And we pray that it will be done tonight. Let your hand touch your people. Let them be blessed and empowered as we continue with you. In Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen.
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 Victory for Jesus.
Satan has fallen.
And heaven.
Our home.
We thank the Lord for his message once again, and I believe it has been by his favor that we are alive today. Tonight we just want to continue what we started last Wednesday. We titled the message, Honoring Your Works. That's what came up at the end. Honoring Your Works. Amen.
Amen.
As human beings, from morning to evening, we speak, we talk. The words we speak are very important. We learn from many of the Bible passages that every word that we are speaking must be word that is full of grace and full of salt. Amen.
Amen.
Many people don't take their words very seriously. And beloved, I want to encourage you, especially when you are angry, especially when you are upset, especially when something is wrong, you be careful the word that comes out of your mouth because every word is being recorded. We read from Matthew 12, the Bible says, by your words you'll be acquitted, by your words you'll be condemned. Words can take us to hell. Jesus warns that when you are angry, I will tell somebody a fool. We shall be liable to the judgment. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved, some of these words are very important. And let us remember that we have a nature in us. That nature was the Adamic nature, the sinful nature. That was what Jesus came to die to take out. We shouldn't allow that nature. That nature is a nature that will pay evil with evil. It's a nature that can let go. So tonight I'm here to encourage you as a child of God that Jesus Christ was the one who faced the worst situation in every life. He was insulted, he was abused, he was accused. He was charged with an allegation that was not even committed by him. Yet, they counted him among criminals. They called him many, many names, evil names. Yet the Bible says he was quiet and like a lamb led to the slaughter. This is the attitude God wants us to put on. From the beginning of his life, we saw humility in Christ. And Father God wants the children whom he has called through his son to have the same nature as his son. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are we here?
Yes.
See, this morning, I was just going through the word of God, spending more time with God, in the presence of God. And we'll talk about this, you know, what was coming upon my hand, this few things I wrote here. As the world is getting to its end, we need to cry a critical cry. Some people, their mind is upset, you know. I'm not saying that when we are in life and God is blessing us, we embrace every blessing we think it. But I'm saying that we need a critical cry in this end time. Because the way the world is going, you know, sin is on the increase, Men are forsaking God. Our leaders don't know anything about God. So we need to cry a critical cry. What does it mean? A critical cry that God save my soul. God help me that on the day of judgment, I will never be cast out. A critical cry of purity in the heart. Matthew chapter 5 verse 8 says that, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Amen.
Amen.
God will always begin from the heart. It doesn't matter how I appear to people, I can appear holy or holiest. If the heart is not right with God, it's all nothing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As wickedness and sin are advancing, and compromising and conforming to worldliness is on the increase, the Christian must be alert. We are living in times where churches, Christians are compromising, conforming. What is compromising? They are agreeing to certain things that are even contrary to the word of God. There are some of the lies that have become notorious, that it has become popular, and when we look at it as if there's nothing wrong. There's nothing that can make sin good. Sin is sin. Amen.
Amen.
We should stand strong, beloved. This is my prayer that I always pray. Lord, help me not to face anything that will make me fall. Something that I cannot overcome. I'm always praying for that. Because the devil means business, beloved. He's making Christians very dull, drowsy, sluggish, lazy in the things of God. But things of the flesh, they are smart. This is the devil we are talking about. He works gradually, bit by bit, bit by bit. And before you realize you are in a certain level where you know that the connection between your God is drawing far. And that's why God is waking us up. We should never compromise. We should never conform our nature as the worldly people. We don't look at them and learn from them. This is what God was putting on my heart. If God was serious in bringing about our salvation, why would he play, why would we play games with our undying soul? This is what another thing the Lord laid in our roots. If God was serious in bringing about our salvation, the seriousness of God, nobody should forget. Because that day, God will remind you. Do you remember I came down here and became like you? I was insulted, they spit on my face because of you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, I was serious in bringing about your salvation. So the question I was asking, why would we play games with our undying soul? I can play games with anything, but not my soul. How do you do that? If you care about your soul, sometimes when we go at evangelism, we ask people, would you sell your one eye? Sell your one eye for $1 million? He was a no. Why would I just take one eye off and go and collect money? I don't know it. And we say, see how much valuable your eyes is to you. How much more your whole body, your soul. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is something God has created that will not die. And that is what I'm bringing our attention on. What matters to you in this life? And what matters most to you in this life? I think God should be the most valuable thing. You must put your God first every day. As I was telling Faustine, I said, when you wake up, the first thing, see God, talk to God, read His word before you pick your phone to go and call your people and see messages. Who is more important? Speak to God who has given you eye to see again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, and I tell you the truth, if you don't take this Christian life serious and the precious blood of Jesus that was shed for you and I, God is not going to take us serious. If we come to church, beloved, we must be serious. When we go out, we must be serious. Otherwise, God will never be serious with us. Because, like I said, we begin with our heart. Beloved, this is a time of brokenness. Let's break our heart. Let's humble ourselves. Let's call on our God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us repent daily. Let us stop sinning and strive with all our strength by God's power, mercy, and grace to enter the narrow gate. The topic should be sin, stop sinning. That's all. We can say all the comfortable things. At the end of sanctified child of God through the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When Jesus healed the man, according to John 5 verse 14, when Jesus healed the man in the temple, the man who has been there for 38 years, who was going to heal this man? You have been sinful, I've been sinful all my life. Who was going to save me? Can money do that? Can my head of state? Can my father or mother? No. Until Jesus came in and he healed this man. And one thing he told him, John 5, 14. Later, Jesus found him in the temple and said to him, see, you are well again. See, you are well again. Stop sinning or something worse will happen to you. We are well now. You know, it's like yesterday I fell. I did something wrong. I lied. I stole. I lusted after something. I forgave. I did some wrong thing. And I went to my God and said, Lord, forgive me. The Lord have compassion on me. He has forgiven me. And he was telling this man, see, you are well again. I tell myself, Pastor Samuel, see, today Jesus has made me well again. He has forgiven me. And he's well saved. That stop sinning. Why would Jesus tell the man after healing him? What is more important? He has got his healing. But Jesus was telling him, stop sinning. Why Jesus said, God, that? Sin will bring curse. Sin will kill. Sin will destroy your life. Sin will make you regret for all eternity. So, beloved child of God, run away from sin. Anybody who will try to entice you to do something wrong and put this God in a small box and be your own box, run away from that person. You came into this world alone. You are going to depart alone. See, you are well again. Stop sinning. Or something worse will happen to you. What is something worse? Hellfire. The lake of fire. Many people who are well and going back to the same lifestyle, he says something worse. So Jesus told the man, and I believe he said all of us. Amen.
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 Now, beloved, let's say a little bit about words because of how we are going to pray. You know, when I was gathering the verses, these two, three verses came into my mind, and I want us to read it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Come with me to. Okay, let's go to our main verse. Proverbs 6, verse 1 to 5. Proverbs 6, verses number 1 to 5. What's looking for? Okay. So here I read quickly. My son, if you become surety of your friend, if you are shaking hands in a place for a stranger, you are snared by the words of your mouth. You are taken by the words of your mouth. And let's see what we can say about this. Anytime you open up your mouth to say anything to someone, I will come. I will do this. Bible says that you are ensnared by your words. It means that word is written. You must be a truthful person to fulfill that. If you are not able to fulfill that, then let us be careful when we are speaking, we see the words we speak so that we honor it. Anytime you speak a word and do not honor it, you have become a liar. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you are ensnared by your words. I said last time, if you have stood here and promised, do that promise. Or go back to whom you promised and plead that please have mercy on me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are snared by the words of your mouth. You are taken by the words of your mouth. This is God's word. Dearly beloved, this passage is to wake every child of God, every human being up. Because every careless word that we say, we must give an account for it to our God. Amen.
Amen.
And God is begotten a truthful children. The devil is a liar and father of lies. So he trained his children to lie in society. Lying is just lying. There is nothing like little or big lie. That's why we don't even have to take lies to joke. We must stop it. It is dangerous and it is taking many to destruction. Lies. The lies we spoke 10 years ago, we must repent and ask for forgiveness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because, beloved, like I said last time, this message is a wake-up message. I see myself in this sort of this area. You open up your mouth to say something, you cannot do it. Tomorrow I'll meet you here. You can't do it. You went to that brother, that sister said, borrowed me this money, and this time you were not able to give the money back. And you don't even care to go back to plead. Beloved, the nature of Christ must be our nature. We can't be Christians just by our mouth. And these are the things the devil is stealing people's mind. We think it is ignored. I beg you tonight, let the Bible say, when it's snare by your way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Verse 3. So do this, my son, and deliver yourself. For you have come into the hand of your friend. Deliver yourself. Go and humble yourself. Plead with your friend. Humble yourself. Take away that pride. And go to that brother and sister. Go to that church and say that, look, I'm sorry, I did this, I did that, I did that. But how can I put it right? How can I do this? Reason with the person. That's what the Bible is saying. And that way you are not condemned. Amen.
Amen.
So when we preached this last Wednesday, beloved, I know it's not easy, but everybody, I'm being very careful. Any word I'm saying as a promise, I have to make sure I fulfill it. We need this grace of God to do this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. You see, like I told you, the other brother says that the Lord revealed to you that there's a compartment in the living room where people promise and fail. They don't honor their words. They speak anyhow. If words are nothing, then beloved, we don't have to care. They are swearing and cast words, and we can all swear. The words count. Words. Amen.
Amen.
So Jesus said in Matthew 5, anyone who becomes angry with his brother or sister without any cause, you love it together. God is not saying you shouldn't be angry. But when we are angry and we think we are better and somebody is like the ground, then we call them names. Foolish, useless, idiot. Beloved, may the Lord forgive us.
Amen.
This is not my words. Jesus told us and warned us about words in Matthew 5. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me quickly read that. Matthew chapter 5. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So let's check the Matthew chapter 5. Now I'm not finding the verse. Let's check it. Verses number 20. Your right eye causes you to think, plug it out, because it's better for you to have one eye to enter into heaven than to have two eyes. And Bible says also certain matters written in the same chapter. When you have a problem with your brother, don't leave it for overnight, because Proverbs is going to confirm it. And again, that God knows that will fall angry. Somebody will offend you. Somebody will step on your foot. Somebody will insult you. Somebody will do something very bad to you. But Jesus is
Matthew
5:20. Thank you. Jesus is our best example. He was insulted. He was abused. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But he opened not his mouth and insult anyone.
29.
Sometimes we distant ourselves because of what that sister and brother did. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's not the 29.
5:29.
No, the 29 is plug your eyes off. Amen.
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 Hallelujah. So don't worry about it. I think it's still there. And he says that if anyone says to his brother, you know, you fool, you shall be liable to judgment. Amen. Let me read from this. Says, but let your yes be yes and let your no be no. These are words. You have done somebody, someone is asking, you need not to swear this, this, and that. It is yes. Whether you believe it or you don't believe, I've said the truth. Fine. And you have to take it. You You don't have to argue with someone because you are not God. You cannot see people's mind. You cannot know their heart. You can only see what they say. So you don't have to continue to argue with your brother or your sister. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible says, let your yes be yes and your no be no. For whatever is more than this is from the evil one. And you have heard that it was said that eye for eye, tooth for tooth. But I tell you to resist an evil person. But whoever slaps you on the right cheek, turn the other to him as well. Turn other to him also. If anyone wants to see you and take away your tunic, let him have your cloak also. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when you continue here, he says that you have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor as yourself, but I say to you, love your enemies, and it keeps on going. So let's see, all these things are what will transpire between you and someone. And all what you want to make sure is that whether you are giving a promise, whether you are being offended, whatever that is coming out of your mouth, it should be something that is good, full of grace, and full of mercies that impact life to others. Coming back to verse 4, it says that give sleep not to your eyes, nor slumber to your eyelids. We want to repeat this verse and again and again. When you have offended someone, give sleep not to your eyes. Don't think you are perfect, so the person has to come and beg you. Sometimes, because of humility, you admit it is why you're right. God is the one who pleads your cause. Hallelujah. If you have said something to someone and you have forgotten, Bible says, don't wait anymore. Go back and make things right. Give sleep. Give no sleep to your eyes. No slumber to your eyelids. Deliver yourself as you flee from the hand of the hunter and the like a bear from the hand of the father. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So this is what Christ is talking to us about. The words that proceed out of our mouths. Your yes just have to be yes, your no have to be no. And things that come from this, that beyond, brings sin all the time into our lives. Amen.
Amen.
Let me give you just one, see, King Herod, come with me, Mark chapter 6, verse 21, quickly. Mark chapter 6. This is a king, so even the wealthy people, they don't take for granted the way they speak. What King Herod did in his time, Mark chapter 6, I read from verses number 21. So it says, then an opportune day came, and when Herod on his birthday gave a feast for his nobles, the high officers, and the chief men of Galilee. And when Herodias, the daughter herself, came in and danced and pleased Herod, and those who sat with him, the king said to the girl, ask me whatever you want, and I will give it to you. This is a promise. So listen carefully. The girl was dancing, and he was so touched. He was so moved. And these are some of the things. You know, it doesn't matter, you're so excited. We are doing something in the church. Yet everybody is helping. God knows how I want to help. But make sure that whatever you want to say, that I want to do this to help, you will do it. That's exactly what Christ is saying about our ways. So here, the Bible says that, and it says that, and then Herodian doctor himself came in and danced, and pleased Herod, and those who sat with him. The king said to the girl, ask him whatever you want, and I will give it to you. This is a big saying, whatever you want. See, he was so excited, he was blinded by his excitement. Whatever you want can be, even everything, even though he give a condition to the half of my kingdom. It is a dangerous quest. And listen to the reply. He also swore to her, whatever you ask me, I'll give you up to half of my kingdom. So she went out and said to her mother, what shall I ask? And she said, the head of John the Baptist. See? Where's? He didn't know he was actually giving a word to his worst enemy. Because the wife and the daughter hate John the Baptist. But the devil blinded this man and gave this promise. And here we are. What do you want me to give you? The head of John the Baptist. Immediately she came in with haste to the king and asked, saying, I want you to give me at once the head of John the Baptist on a platter. And the king was exceedingly sorry. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This passage is very sad. He loved John the Baptist. He knew he was a righteous man. But because of words, the way he spoke, hallelujah. Listen. Immediately, he said that, and the king was exceedingly sorry. Exceedingly means more than sorry. He was really, really, really sorry. Totally sorry. Yet because of the oath and because of those who sat with him, he did not want to refuse them. Oh, he swore an oath. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Immediately the king sent an execution and commanded his head to be brought. And he went and beheaded him in the prison. Mm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved, we must be very careful. These are worthy people. King Herod wasn't a Christian. But they honored the word. How much more God? Beloved, any time you want to speak, pray. All of us. James says that in James chapter 2, verse 1, he says, if anybody doesn't make mistakes in talking, then he is a perfect person. We all make mistakes. We speak to people in different ways. We think that we are right, someone is wrong. But before God, you are also wrong. Jesus is our best example. He was insulted. They lied against him. But he was right. Amen.
Amen.
We spoke about Ananias and Sapphira. They were the people who went and sold their land to come and support the church. Church business. They have a good intention. But after selling the land, the devil came in. You cannot give that all this huge money to the church. Who has ever even given $10,000 like that? You have $20,000, give $10,000 and it's enough. That money is huge money, but before God, they became liars. Because what they said in the beginning, they couldn't fulfill their way. We are going to sell and support the church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved, our ways. I can't have time to talk about Jephthah when you read the book of Judges 11. He made a terrible promise, but it was out of his heart. But let's quickly jump there, and then we can pray. Come to me to Judges. So, not all the stories, they are there to help us when we are talking, when we are making promises, those little promises. Judges chapter 11. We read in verses number 29. Judges 11. Are you there? Judges chapter 11, verse 29. Then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jephthah, and he passed through Gilead, Manasseh, passed through Mizpah of Gilead, and from Mizpah, Gilead in advance towards the people of Ammon. And Jephthah made a vow to the Lord and said, let us listen to the words he said. Jephthah made a vow to the Lord and said, verses number 31, sorry. He says that if you indeed deliver the people of Ammon into my hands, this is the promise, this is what he's saying, verse 10. And Jephthah made a vow to the Lord and said, if you indeed deliver the people of Ammon into my hands, because they were going on a big war and needed to overcome Ammon. So this was the prayer he prayed. Then it will be that whatever, listen to him too, he said, whatever. Like King Herod said, say, whatever, ask whatever you want. He said, whatever comes out of the doors of my house to meet me, then when I return in peace from the people of Ammon, shall surely be the Lord's, and I will offer it up as a burnt offering. Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the Lord help us to learn quickly from this great man of God. Yes, that was a great man of God. It wasn't easy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Verse 32, and Jephthah advanced towards the people of Ammon to fight against them, and the Lord delivered them into his hands. And he defeated them from Arar as far as Min, 20 cities, and to Abel Karamim with very great slaughter. Thus the people of Ammon were subdued before the children of Israel. They won the victory. Now the words he spoke. When Jephthah came to his house at Mizpah, as they were coming, he has promised, for whatever comes out, I will sacrifice it unto the Lord. And when Jephthah came to his house at Mizpah, there was his daughter coming out to meet him with timbrels and dancing, and she was his only child. Beside him, he had neither son nor daughter. See how beautiful this is going to be. One child, only daughter. When the daughter was excited, the dad has gone to the war and they won victory over 20 cities. And she was coming and praising God. Listen, verse 35. And it came to pass when he saw her that he tore his clothes and said, "Alas, my daughter, you have brought me very low. You are among." He says that you have brought me very low. You are among those who trouble me. For I have given my word to the Lord and I cannot go back on it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have given my word to the Lord and I cannot go back on it. So she said to my father, if you have given your word to the Lord, do to me according to what has gone out of your mouth. Because the Lord has avenged you of your enemies, the people of Ammon. This story is so sad. You want to cry. When they were bringing joy home, sorrow was meeting him. How could he kill his own daughter? Words. The words of our mouth. Listen to Ecclesiastes chapter 5. We'll finish soon. Do not be rash with your mouth. Ecclesiastes 5 verse 2. Do not be rash with your mouth and let not your heart utter anything hastily before God. Have you promised anything in the church? I will do this, I will do that. Did you lift your hands? Did you do something? Did you do it? For God is in heaven and you are on earth. Therefore, let your words be few. Few words. Not too much talking. For a dream comes through much activity. And a fool's voice is known by his many words. See, let us learn. When we are talking about someone, beloved, let's talk with empathy. The person can be wrong. He has done the wrong thing. Let's talk with empathy. Because I can be wrong tomorrow. Again, I shouldn't see myself as better than anyone. That is where God will have mercy upon me, mercy upon you, and to forgive you. Beloved, these words are very important. He said, listen, for a dream comes through much activity, and a fool's voice is known by his many words. People who, as Bible says, they are fools, they talk and talk, they come to God. And so when he says that when you make a vow to God, do not delay to pay it. For he has no pleasure in fools. Pay what you have vowed. Better not to vow than to vow and not pay. Do not let your mouth cause your flesh to sin. Nor say before the messenger of God that it was an error. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't even know. Beloved, may the Lord have mercy upon us.
Amen.
Beloved, may the Lord have mercy upon us.
Amen.
And tonight we are going to pray, beloved. We don't want to play games again with the words we speak. If yesterday you were angry and said something, or you promised someone you will come or do this, or you have promised God to come to church every Sunday, every Wednesday, this time and stuff, and you are not doing it, we are going to pray. Because you have heard, we have all heard, that this word that these people spoke, they have to honor it. If you don't honor it, it's going to be against your name. Dearly beloved, brothers and sisters, fathers, mothers, Christian life must be taken very serious. Let us remember one another. If I have to give her to Mama Sarah, let me give her a word that will not keep her in the place where she will also sin against God. Last time we spoke about many things, but I believe this topic we'll talk more about it later. You know, say, Mama Sarah, if you go say hello or greet your husband for me, we need to put it in a way where I will not make you sin, because probably you might forget. Amen. Mama Sarah, if you have a chance, if you could remember, then give this regards to your husband for me. All these things doesn't agree. You're not ensnared by the way. Because once you know, okay, you have accepted to do it, and you have to do it. But the way I say it, probably you might forget it, not intentionally, it will not be a sin for you. Because you admitted that I gave conditions. Conditions are that if you have a chance, if you remember, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Beloved, we want to pray tonight. And we have heard about this story about Herod, about Sapphira and Ananias. We have heard about Jephthah. And the very important words Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 2 have said. Let us be very careful. If you are going to work, clock the time exact. When you finish, clock the exact time. Don't make rule at a work with people. Oh, this one is for the government. No. You will stand before God guilty. Amen.
Amen.
One sister was asking the friend, can't you bring this thing from the work room? Because my brother and my sister is sick. Just a little bit. And the friend was asking the sister, if that work was your work, and you have employees there, and they're taking things from your work and giving to their brothers and to, would you be happy? And the sister said, what you are saying is very true. You see? Because it's government, it doesn't matter. Come and give me only 1% or all this and that. There are many things, lying to children. I'll buy chocolate for you, don't do it. It's a sin. Hallelujah. Wednesday, all of us came out with some few things we've been doing, all of us. And beloved, God wants us to hear this. We are God's people. We have been born again. Christ never do that. Somebody says, ask something that, and some pastors cracked jokes before. And I said, look, for me, I'm not here to condemn anyone. But I didn't see Christ cracking many jokes and laughing. Some of the jokes are all lies. And we brought in Anansi from Ghana. It's all lies. Anansi is not a human being. But they will talk about Anansi like he's a human being. Is it a true story? No. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, there are some of the traditions we think Christians have come to condemn them. No. It is from demons. How can you tell me that Anansi went to has children and went to work here? Where? Oh my. I used to tell a lot. I know a lot of Anansi. You call it cave bearing or something like that. It is not true. Amen.
Amen.
But all these things, you know, I'm telling you, if you are in Christ, all these things God will let you know. All these things God will let you know. Your words are very important. Amen. Whatever we are saying, don't use it to joke anymore. Let us try our best. We fall short, but let us try, but God will help us. Amen.
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 And tonight I want us to pray that the things we have done in the past, sometimes we didn't fail to ask for forgiveness. The words we gave to someone, and the words someone gave to us, and we accepted that we'll do it. You are looking for a baby, a child. You are looking for a job. You are looking for a marriage. You are looking for this. Lord, if you give it to me, I will never miss church. You have gone through 3 kids. Today you come to church maybe once every 2 weeks, once every month, twice. But when you needed, you were crying. You were kneeling. Spending time in prayer. There are some of us, we say, Lord, if you help me to come to overseas, this, we don't honor them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are getting tired now. The devil is making us forgotten our vows. But remember that God takes our somewhere serious. Tonight, let's be on our feet. Let's be on our feet, beloved. It's a moment of repenting and asking God for forgiveness. I am not standing here to preach this message to make myself as if I'm there. No. We all need to repent from the worst, beloved. Those of you, come here. Come this way, please, my daughter, so that we can all gather together and pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I think one of you can shift a little bit here so that we are not many here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved, the devil in business, his business is to destroy souls. The devil is happy that many people are not making it to heaven. Why? Because the same devil who deceived Adam and Eve is using the same principles. Today, men and women are not even following what? We are not following the things, beloved, that will help us repent. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus said, call me in times of trouble and I'll hear you and show you greater things that you do not know. This Christian life is not by my strength, it's not by your strength. We need the hand of God. The days are evil, child of God. Your life is in your Father, it's in Jesus Christ. And we have to make sure that we remain in Him. The devil is our greatest enemy. He wants us, you know, Bible says, little living, living the whole door. He needs something little just to spot you and accuse you. But tonight I'm here to tell you that it doesn't matter the nonsense that we have said. God is a forgiving God. He is forgiving us and He has forgiven us in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
All what we are asking, I'm going to ask the Lord, guide us. Our ways, let it be wholesome. Let it be ways that impart grace, full of salt. Let it be ways that are true. Bible says that the spirit of truth with the world cannot accept. Because they don't know Him, neither sees Him, but you know Him. And He'll be with you and abide in you. Beloved, as you stand, just close your eyes. I am begging you to humble yourself tonight, beloved. All of us, let us humble ourselves and begin to ask the Lord, my God. We are living in times where lies are ruling. We don't take lie as a lie. As long as it's going to help my brother, my sister, it doesn't matter. Beloved, lies is dangerous. The devil is a father of lies. He himself is a liar and a father of lies. Our Father is a truthful God, a faithful God. And so tonight, before we tap into this, beloved, just begin to thank the Lord that you are alive. Thank the Lord for the mercy. Thank the Lord for His favor. Thank the Lord for His mercy. Thank the Lord for His faithfulness, His grace. Begin to thank Him, beloved. Give Him the glory. He knows why He has called you out of the darkness into His marvelous light. And I can tell you tonight that whatever God wants to do to bring you to the kingdom of God, He has done it continuously doing. This message is like Jesus Himself is here and talking to us and my children. Don't learn from these people. I am your Father, I'm your God. Learn from me. Speak the right words. Stop accusing people with evil words. Don't insult people. Don't retain insult with insult. Don't lie. Of deception. Bible says God will destroy falsehood and all lies. So tonight you are just thanking the Lord for this favor. That God is with us. His word, some of them will come to rebuke us and encourage us, wake us up. Some of them will come and straighten our path because we fall. Without Him, we are nothing. Begin to just pray this prayer, thanking Him for this opportunity. Father, we bless you. King of kings and Lord of lords. Tonight we are not doing this, Lord, because, Lord, we are perfect. We are calling on you tonight, that Lord. Help us with our ways to be seasoned with salt. Talk to the Lord, beloved. Talk to the Lord, beloved. Father, we praise you tonight. May your holy name be exalted. Thank you for the opportunity, Lord, of repentance. Because in the lake of fire, there's no repentance. People have died cannot repent. We can repent and tonight we repent of our sins, my Lord. Father, we pray, we come before you that take away that pride. when we are so prideful that we don't even respect those who have offended us, Lord. But we have offended you most, Lord. Our words have gone very far. Tonight we thank you that, Lord, you have not counted our sins against us according to the book of Psalms 32. You have not imputed our sins against us. Have mercy upon us, Lord. Talk to God. Talk to God. Father, we bless you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I have made you too small in my eyes. Oh, Lord, forgive me. I love believing the lie that you were unable to help me. But human and show yourself strong. And in my soul, oh Lord, be magnified. Oh Lord, be magnified.
Lord of Lords, have mercy, my God.
deliver us from the power of sin. Deliver us from the power of darkness. May our body be consecrated. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we lose chains of the enemy. Any chains that break sinful nature, we break and tear down stronghold tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, that our bodies will not be longer slaves to sin, slaves to fear, but slaves to righteousness. Bible says we did not receive the strength that makes us a slave to fear again. We have received the spirit of sonship. Therefore we cry, Abba. The spirit itself bear with our spirit that we are the children of God. And we shall children that are heirs and heirs with Christ. Father, in Jesus' name, we pray that may your hand touch us tonight, Lord. Have mercy, my Lord. Deliver us and wash us from every contamination, every unrighteousness. Have mercy upon us, Lord. We don't want to stand before you. We don't want to lift your name and say hallelujah, hallelujah, when our hearts are far away from you. Lord, forgive us. Help us to be serious with the salvation you purchased with your own sinless life for us. We bless you tonight. Have mercy, have mercy, have mercy. Lord, call on the Lord tonight. Have mercy upon our life. Deliver us from every principles of the enemy. Any principle that has been accepted in our society, that is lying principle, may we not go about it, Father. We pray that may your word guard our life. Tonight we pray and say, may your holy name be exalted. Psalm chapter 5 verse 4 says, for you are not a God who takes pleasure in wickedness, nor shall evil dwell with you. Bible says that God, he's not happy. He doesn't take pleasure when his children are involved in wickedness, in sin. And the Bible says that evil will not dwell with God. Beloved, evil will not dwell with God. It says it's a holy God. The kingdom of God is full of holiness. The entrance to the kingdom is about holiness. So we are praying tonight. When you continue, verse 5 says that the boastful shall not stand in your sight. You hate all workers of iniquity. Verse 6. You shall destroy those who speak falsehood. The Lord abhors bloodthirsty and deceitful men. Bible says God will destroy those who speak falsehood, those who practice lies, those who love lies. And Bible says that deceitful men will be destroyed by him. We are praying and asking the Lord, that Lord, let no wickedness abound in us. Let no evil abound in us. Have mercy upon our lives. May we know that, Lord, you have done all you have to do to save our souls. Beloved, begin to pray right now. I don't want you to be quiet. Just talk to the Lord tonight. Your life is not in the hands of your enemies. No demon, no weapon of the enemy shall destroy you because you belong to the King of Kings. Talk to the Lord tonight. Talk to the Lord and ask him. Father, in Jesus' mighty name, we pray against any spirit of deception, any spirit of lies. Bible says you shall destroy the boastful, those who boast in life. Tonight we are praying in the name of Jesus. Have mercy upon your people. Deliver us from the power of the enemy. Deliver us from the principles of deception in this end time. As we have just read, Bible says you take no pleasure in wickedness. Any area of our lives, that wickedness is ruling. Any type of sin. Father, we come before you. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Lord, have mercy, my God. Help us to be more serious. What you have told us to do, help us to do. What you have told us not to do, help us not to do. Bible says in 1 John, he who practices righteousness is righteous as he who is righteous. He who practices evil is from the enemy, because the enemy, the devil, begin to sin from the beginning of life. Father, we are praying tonight in Jesus' name. May we look at your word and allow your word to transform our life. Father, take away all those unrighteousness, all those wickedness, all those deception from our mouths, Lord. Any area, may we be faithful to our husbands, our wives. May we be faithful to our children. May we not lie with our mouth, even on documentation. May we stop doing all those diabolic things. We pray that, Lord, season us. Our strength is not enough. Guide us, my God. That, Father, we will not lie anymore. We will not speak words that we cannot carry out. We will not receive words that we cannot carry out. Have mercy, have mercy. Pray, beloved, pray, 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 pray to the Lord.